Starting a new project requires a careful assessment of the cash flows that the project will generate in the future. We need to measure the approximate amounts and the point in time when they will be received or paid. This is critical for making an informed decision and is one of the main variables that help us decide whether a project is feasible or not. Determining the value of a project can be challenging because of the time value of money. As we already know, a dollar earned in the future is not equal to a dollar earned today. Discounting cash flows and obtaining their present value is a way to account for this. For example, if an investor wants to buy a given stock, he would first estimate the future cash flow the stock would generate, discount those cash flows, and then add their present values. If the amount that is obtained is greater than the initial investment, the investment is feasible and will create value. Otherwise, it is not valid from a financial perspective. Here is the net present value formula. Net present value is equal to the sum of discounted cash flows minus the initial investment. Let's calculate the net present value of a given project in Excel. A firm plans to build a plant that will produce the following cash flows: 30 in year 1, 120 in year 2, 200 in year 3, 120 in year 4 and 5. After year 5, the plant will be completely obsolete and will have to be replaced. The plant costs 500 and the firm's marginal borrowing rate is 10%. The financial director of the firm needs to assess whether to go through with the investment or not. Calculating the net present value of the project would allow him to make an informed decision. You can see the net present value formula on the right part of the screen. The first thing that I will do is discount the cash flows. In order to do that, above each of them, I will type the period in which they will be generated. The initial investment of 500 is today. We will mark the current times as 0, because it is 0 years from now. The next cash flow of 30 is after 1 year. That's why I'll type a 1. Then, we have 2 above the next cash flow, given that it is in 2 years, and so on. Now we can discount the cash flows easier. The initial investment doesn't need to be discounted. That's why we'll start with the first cash flow of 30. In order to discount it, we need to divide it by 1 plus the interest rate, elevated to the first degree. The degree to which we are elevating depends on how many years from now the cash flow is that we are discounting. So, for example, the next cash flow will be elevated to the second degree because it is 2 years from now, and so on. The formula that we typed can be pasted directly to the right if we fix the cell references of the interest rate with dollar signs. This is how we obtain the discounted cash flows that will result from building the plant. Let's sum them with the initial investment that is necessary, and we'll find the net present value of the project. The sum is negative, which means the project is not feasible and should be avoided. The concept of net present value is very important, as it stands at the core of some fundamental financial techniques. It is applicable in many cases when a person or a corporation faces an important financial decision.